George Sampson.
Viggo Venn. Diversity. Mass voice guy.
Colin Thackeray. Tokyo Miles.
Richard Jones.
Off and you get this.
World of showbiz seems a million miles away.
It's Paul, a mobile phone salesman from South Wales.
By day, I sell mobile phones. My dream is to spend my life doing what I feel that I was born to do.
Paul, what are you here for today, Paul?
To sing opera. I've always wanted to sing as a career. Confidence has always been sort of like a difficult thing for me. I've always found it a little bit difficult to be completely confident in myself.
Okay, ready when you are. So you work at Carphone Warehouse, and you did that. I wasn't expecting that.
No, neither was I.
This was a complete breath of fresh air. I thought you were absolutely fantastic.
You have an incredible voice. I think if you keep singing like that, you are going to be one of the favourites to win this whole competition.
I think that we've got a case of a little lump of coal here that is going to turn into a diamond.
Okay, moment of truth, young man. Piers.
Absolutely yes.
Amanda.
Yes.
Paul, you are through to the next round.
Congratulations.
Unbelievable. I had those pimples.
You must be over the moon.
I am. A bit shocked at
home. Oh, yeah.
And as Paul heads home happy, the judges think they might have found something special in Cardiff.
I like shows where somebody isn't a professional, has a talent, isn't aware of it, has a normal job, and then you see something else. Mm. I like that. Mm. And that's what that guy had.
Undiscovered little gem.
Yeah.
A frog that will turn
back here again this year to dance.
We first met George a year ago when he auditioned hoping for a better life for him and his family.
Family's not great. It's not exactly rich. But we're surviving. This competition could be a big chance.
George did well in his first audition.
Never seen anything like that ever. Brilliant. Brilliant.
But when it came to the judges choosing the semi-finalists, Simon wasn't able to convince the other two, and George's dream was over.
Unfortunately, you weren't quite good enough.
When I was told I wasn't through last year, I was gutted because all you've done basically comes to nothing. So that's when I decided I have to come back and try again.
What's new? What you got for us this year?
Bigger moves, bigger, better moves.
Yeah.
I'm dancing on the streets of Manchester just to get better. Some of the money I raise goes to lessons, it goes to petrol for my mum to drive me around, and if without it, I wouldn't have been able to pay to get here today. I want it even more than last year, because last year I really wanted it, but now it's just, it's one of them things, it's inside your head and you've got to get it.
It's all yours.
Good luck.
Last year I was nervous, but this year I reckon I'm gonna be twice as nervous.
We met you last year, didn't we?
Yeah.
You're taller.
I know.
Much taller.
I know.
What did you do last year? You were a dancer?
Yeah.
Right. And you didn't make it through to the live shows, did
yeah,
you?
Yeah, didn't make it through to the live
no,
shows.
No, I think, for me, I always thought you should have done, to be honest with you. So what have you learnt in the last 12 months?
Last 12 months, I've just trained harder and I've just got bigger and better with moves and
good
everything.
Attitudes.
So
you've got to raise the bar a bit this year, right?
Yeah.
OK, off you go.
Come on, George.
Really want him to do well.
I do, yeah.
Okay, George, you know I'm a fan, and I seriously fought for you last year to get into the finals, and I was really disappointed you didn't. Last year, I thought you were fantastic. This year, I didn't. I thought you were phenomenal.
I've never heard that word before. Not from him, anyway.
The best dancer we have had by a clear mile.
We like people like you. You know, people who don't get quite far enough and go away, think about it and think, you know what, I'm going to prove them wrong.
Amanda.
I completely agree with Piers. Great spirit, great, lovely smile, great face, great energy. Just really cool.
Piers, yes or no?
Well, I'm a yes, obviously. Brilliant.
Amanda?
Yes!
George Sampson. Three yeses.
Absolutely fantastic, man. You must be over the moon.
I am.
Speechless.
Yes.
I'm really...
I don't know what to say.
Said this last year.
Yeah, you're right.
Mm-hmm. It was awful.
You're right.
Was
always awful. Said this kid got something.
I'm so glad you came back. Well done, and we'll see you in the next round.
All right.
Yeah?
Yep, definitely.
Well done, mate. Well, hello. Thank you.
He's got to shoot straight off to catch a train.
Hi, guys. And who are you?
We're Diversity.
Okay. And who's Diversity? What is Diversity?
We're a street dance group.
Who put the group together?
Group's made up of three sets of brothers and friends. So I mean, like, we've just known each other for absolutely
What about
years.
The little one?
I know, this is, you know, he hasn't got a brother, but he's he's cute, he's cute.
And what are the chances of you guys winning this? Good?
Good, good. We'd like to think so. We'd like to think so.
Okay, well, look, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Good luck.
Thank you.
Where are you going? Is that you done?
No, I've got it.
You're going back on? Do you want me to take that?
Finish for that.
Thank you. There you are.
I have a dream.
Gymnastic troupe based in Ashford, Middlesex. We've come to Britain's Got Talent because we've watched the programme for many years, and it was something different for the kids to aim for.
We're all from different backgrounds, but we're all of gymnastics. It's what brought us together, really. We've got a good friendship, a good bond between all of us. We are like a close family. Neil's like our strict parent.
I've trained with these kids for many years.
We get up at 6 in the morning for school and then train.
I think they're probably a little bit nervous.
Good luck, guys.
But I think they'll do okay.
So there is the nervous element of the judges and the buzzers and the crowd and everything, but today is very important for us.
Hi.
Hi there.
And who are you all, please?
We are Spellbound.
And gymnastics?
It is, yes.
OK, and tell me the age range here.
We're going from 12 to 24.
I'm sorry, I can't believe you're... How old are you?
18.
18?
Yep.
OK. I can believe that six-pack now. It's just unbelievable. And tell me, what's the dream here?
The dream is impress you guys, impress the audience, and go into the Royal Variety performance.
Good. Best of luck, guys. Good luck.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I have never seen anything like that in my life. I thought, you know, once again we were going to get some really boring gymnastics display, but it was very clever, really, really smart.
It was absolutely faultless. That some of the stuff that was going on, I didn't think was humanly possible. Outstanding.
The pace of it got bigger and bigger as it went on. Momentum built, the drama built, the story was great, and in the end it reached this thrilling conclusion that had the whole theatre going crazy.
Okay, we're gonna vote. Here's yes or no.
Absolute yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
This is very simple. You've got three yeses. Well done.
Absolutely incredible. Incredible!
Wow!
Wow! Wow! Wow! Wow.
Absolutely! Brilliant. Listen to them. Listen to them.
Seven.
Really buzzing.
Real
freezer. Faultless.
I'm Jamie Dowell, I'm 24, I'm from Ayrshire in Scotland, and today I'm going to be singing for the judges. I sing all the time, in the car, in the shower, but I've never actually performed professionally before. I work as a support worker, which involves looking after young adults with disabilities. It's a good job to have, and I absolutely love doing it, but singing's my dream. I'm feeling very nervous about my audition today. The closer it gets, you know, the more butterflies you get in your stomach, and the more nervous I become. I've never done this before.
Well, it's a big stage, and it's ready for you.
Sometimes what happens to me is, like, my leg starts to shake, so I'm kind of hoping that won't happen. Can control my voice, then it should, everything should be okay.
Hello, welcome. What's your name, please?
My name's Jai.
Where are you from, Jai?
I'm from Scotland.
Scotland?
Yeah.
What are you doing for a living currently, Jai?
At the moment, I work as a support worker.
Okay, very good. This is your big moment. Very best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Come on, Jai. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
No man, no madness, though their sad power may prevail, can possess, conquer my country's heart, they rise to fail. She is eternal, long before nations' lines were drawn.
Into it, I could see you sort of trembling and welling up, and then you belted that last bit out with everything you had. Well done.
Thank you so much.
Oh, Jay, your little knees were trembling throughout that. Your voice is so powerful. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Absolutely nailed it. You've got heart, emotion, and you know, you can let go of the microphone, man. Relax, you did it.
Okay, let's vote on it, Jai. David.
Yes.
Amanda.
I'm proud to say yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Jai. It's three yeses. Many congratulations. What about now?
What about today? Oh, tremendous. It's lost behind. Words we can never find. Maybe
before it's too late. Maybe before it's too late. Pudsey and...
Pudsey and Ashley, or Ashley and Pudsey?
Ashley and Pudsey.
It really matters which way around you go.
It does.
Because once it's there, it's there forever.
Let me tell you. Bitter.
No, I'm not bitter, but just make sure you're sure.
Okay, I actually go for my 11th birthday. He was in a little box, and my mum wrapped him up, and then I opened it.
Taylor, out the way. So what you wanted. There you are, listen, look at your face. You got little tears in your eyes.
Me and Pudsey have an amazing bond together. I walk him, I feed him, I groom him, I do everything with him. He's just amazing and I love him so much.
Ashley is absolutely devoted to Pudsey. That her whole life, it doesn't revolve around boys, it revolves around Pudsey. It's a bond that you'd never break.
And what is he?
He's a crossbreed. Do you want me to tell you what he is?
Yeah.
He's a Bichon Frise, a Border Collie, and a Chinese Crusty Powder Puff.
Well, what?
Chinese Crusty Powder Puff?
Chinese Crusty Powder Puff?
I've come on Britain's Got Talent because I know Simon's been looking for a lassie for quite a while, so I'm hoping Pudsey could fill them boots.
You seem quite relaxed.
I'm okay. No, I'm not okay. I think Pudsey's quite calm, though.
He seems it.
Yeah, he does. He looks very calm.
Thank you.
You ready for them?
Yes.
Okay, should we do it? It's all
yeah.
To you.
Okay, come on. Thank you.
Go, get you one. Good luck, have fun.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank
you. Good. Right, introduce me, please.
I'm Ashley, and this is my dog, Pudsey.
Pudsey?
Pudsey, yeah.
He's gorgeous. How old is he?
He's 6.
Okay, so tell me about the two of you. Where did you first meet?
My mum gave him to me for my 11th birthday.
Okay, and how old are you?
I'm 16.
Okay, so you're at school?
Yeah.
Okay, so where do you see the two of yourself if you were to win this show in a few years' time? I'm looking for Oscars. Do you think your dog and you could win an Oscar?
Yes.
Oh, he has picked up at that,
look. Yes.
Yeah, he's good Oscar. He's like, yeah.
Good. Best of luck.
Thank you. Pudsey. Come on, Pudsey. Good boy. Ready?
He's a cute little thing, isn't he?
Ready? Sit. Right.
Oh, my gosh.
Head down.
Right. I want him.
Pudsey are adorable. I've been dying to see a dancing dog. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
Well done.
Good boy.
Everything about that was brilliant. Chemistry between the two of you. I was completely blown away.
Thank you.
You know me. I love a dancing dog. I do. And Pudsey's one of the best dancing dogs I've ever seen. We've got this great connection between the two of you. My only criticism would have been I would have put Pudsey in a prehistoric outfit as well. Do you think Pudsey would change if he won the show?
I think he could go a bit diva, maybe. A little bit. He gets what he wants.
Okay, well, we're going to have to vote now.
David, yes or no?
1,000,000% yes. Loved it.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me.
Ashley, and more importantly, Pudsey, you're through to the next round. Three yeses.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
What about the judges' comments? Some great comments.
I know. Oh, it's when they stood up at the end. I was just like, oh, God. That's it was brilliant.
That was heaven for me, because I love the Flintstones. I love dog acts. Heaven.
Yeah. Yes, well done.
Thank you.
Well done. Well done, Pudge.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Pudge. Good boy.
Well done, Ashley.
Good boy, Pudsey Bear.
Spent a lifetime stuck in silence, afraid you'll say something wrong. If no one ever hears it, how we gonna learn your song?
Hi there, we are Calabro.
Do you have day jobs?
I'm a labourer.
I'm a sales assistant on a petrol garage.
I'm a kitchen salesman.
I work in a Japanese restaurant.
I work in a hospital.
Okay, lovely. How long have you guys been a group?
We've been together for about a month now.
A month? Oh, not long. What makes you think after a month that you're good enough to win Britain's Got Talent?
Natural chemistry, I think.
Okay, lovely. Well, whenever you're ready.
There, out in the darkness, a fugitive running, fallen from God.
Didn't expect this.
Fallen from grace, God be my witness, I never shall yield, till we come face to face, till we come face to face. He knows his way in the dark. Mine is the way of the Lord. Those who follow the path of the righteous shall have their reward. And if they fall as Lucifer fell, the flame, the sword. Stars in your multitude, scarce to be counted, filling the darkness with order and light. You are the sentinels, silent and sure, keeping watch in the night, keeping watch in the night. You know your place in the sky, you hold your course and your reign, and each of your seasons returns and returns, and is always the same. And if you fall as Lucifer fell, you fall in flames. And so it must be, for so it is written, on the doorway to paradise, those who falter and those who fall must pay.
I may see him
safe behind bars. I will never rest till then. This I swear I
when the five of you came out, I thought, here we go again, another boy band, this is going to be awful. It was an absolutely brilliant audition.
Brilliant. Thank you. Thank you very much.
It was a faultless performance, guys. It was absolutely fantastic.
Oh, what a great song.
Yeah, I know. It's not an obvious choice of song as well, which is great because we hear the same songs over and over again. I really think this could be very big.
That's astonishing. That is definitely by far one of the strongest auditions I've ever seen.
Thank you.
Oh, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. David?
Yes.
Alicia?
It's a yes from me, guys.
Thank you.
Do you know what? Britain really has got talent. It's four yeses. Like a dream of yours all your life?
It has. It's always been a dream to perform on the Royal Variety Show.
Sure.
And meet the Queen in person, so.
She's very nice. She's very nice. Very easy to chat to. And when you go over for dinner, she's just very normal and down to earth.
Okay, well, listen, Richard, I really wish you the best of luck.
Thank you very much. Do you mind if I join you on
Please.
The table?
I would like that.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to sit here and watch on the screen. Want a cup of tea? I love stuff like this.
Now, I have a gift here. This is a gift which is going to be for one of you judges in just a few moments, but I'm going to leave it there for now. I also have two notebooks. On each of these notebooks, I have different things written. One is for you, Amanda.
Right.
As I flick through, would you mind reading some of these out for me?
Jennifer Aniston, Madonna, Brad Pitt, Taylor Swift, Vin Diesel, Halle Berry, Emma Stone, Tom Hanks.
They're all celebrities, 60 celebrities to be precise. If you could hold your hand flat for me, place your other hand directly on top and just hold it there. I also have one for you, David.
Oh.
This one here is a drinks menu. On every page is a different drink. Please read some out for us.
Cola, Fanta, Mojito.
Vodka, rum, whiskey. I'm right, I was just...
If you could hold your hand flat and place your other hand on top. Now, just with your thumb, lift up, make sure no one sees, and just take a peek at whatever you choose, and then slam it closed for me. And please, could you stand up and just throw them onto the stage, because we no longer need those. Unleash the anger. Perfect.
Good throw, David.
OK, Amanda, we're going to start with yourself. You're thinking of a celebrity, is that correct?
Yes.
Thinking of a celebrity? Just stand up for me. What I need you to do is send your thoughts straight directly into my mind. I need you just with your finger, look me directly in the eye and just touch me just on the forehead there.
Ooh!
You felt that, right?
Yes!
Thank you so much.
Oh my goodness.
Now, what you've just done is you've just directly sent your thoughts into my mind. And I'm now going to very creatively find out who you are thinking of. Now, believe it or not, before I became a magician, I spent 6 years in an origami intensive training center in the heart of Japan. Just so I could be here with you guys doing this right now. Now, am I right in saying this is someone who's very particular about their hair?
Yes.
And I think it's probably a man. Don't give anything away, but I'm going to just... That's perfect. OK, Amanda, please tell us, this wonderful audience, who are you thinking of?
David Beckham.
David Beckham. If I open this up, I've made something very, very special for you to keep. We have Mr. David Beckham.
David Beckham! Wow!
That's amazing!
Now, David, you're still thinking of a drink, is that correct?
Correct.
Would you mind now revealing to us the drink that you've been thinking of?
It's the drink I'm drinking right now.
Which is?
A cup of tea.
A cup of tea!
A cup of tea.
Now, this has been here the whole time. It's been in front of yourself, Simon.
Yeah.
Inside here, ladies and gentlemen, just as you asked for, orange soda! A little bit awkward, but we can still fix this. Don't panic. Could you just reach out your hand just here for me? Just send me that positive energy.
Oh! What is going on?
Wow.
I didn't like it.
So rude. Oh my goodness.
Believe it or not, you've now just filled me with all of your kinetic energy, which allows me to act almost like a microwave, so the can starts to heat up.
Oh, come on.
And it gets hotter and hotter. Please feel it.
What?
Feel the can. It's getting hotter and hotter. Yeah, just make sure that is a sealed can. I asked you think of one drink, you said breakfast tea, was that right?
Correct.
If I open this up, ladies and gentlemen, just what you ordered.
No way.
Tea.
Tea in a can.
Oh.
Please taste it.
It's a proper cup of tea.
Please taste it. Make sure it really is tea.
A delicious cup of tea.
It is tea. Thank you very much. Thank you.
How the hell did you do that?
Hello.
How are you?
I'm very well, thanks. A bit nervous.
That's all good. Right, what's your name?
My name is Tokyo.
Tokyo.
Yeah.
Very nice. And where are you from?
I'm from London.
Yeah, and how old are you?
I'm 32.
I'm kind of nervous, you know.
What would it mean to you to win a show like Britain's Got Talent?
It would mean the world to me, just from my background and everything that I've kind of been up to this day. I grew up in a really rough estate in London's northwest. That definitely played a role in, you know, sticking at music. It was just a way of just releasing any kind of negative energy and pulling it into something positive.
Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you.
David.
Well, you had us from the first moment. You know, you could have heard a pin drop in here. It was really, really fantastic.
Thank you very much.
It was literally like a film score. It just inspired my imagination when I was listening to it.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I think you're really... edgy and really refreshing, and that couldn't have gone any more brilliantly.
Oh,
so
well
done.
Tokyo, what was the song?
So the first piece was Debussy, called Claire de Lune, and then it blended into Ed Sheeran, Bloodstream.
Very clever. We've never really had an act like you on this show before. And was there someone who was like your mentor or who inspired you?
Mr. Morgan, he was the guy who I kind of looked up to as a kid. You know, he's my music teacher.
Yeah.
And if it wasn't for him guiding me and showing me where I could go, I probably wouldn't be here or doing what I'm doing today. So, yeah.
I absolutely love that audition.
Thank you.
Take a vote. David.
It's a yes from me.
Amanda?
Oh, yeah, without doubt. A yes from me.
Thank you, darling.
It's a yes from me, too. Simon? 100%,
Tokyo, you got four yeses.
I'm only human after all. I'm only human after all. Don't put the blame on me.
I like him a lot. I like his energy. He was great.
Hello, what's your name?
Hello, my name is Lee, and for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dec.
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many politically correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs. Special schools, Special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
I'm going to sing you a song that is dedicated actually to my late wife.
Colin, I think it's extraordinary you've come here. The stage is yours.
Thank you very much.
It must have been cold there in my shadow. Never see sunlight on your face. You did your best to make me shine. You always walked a step behind. I was the one with all the glory. Everything that I'd like to be, I could fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. Appeared to go unnoticed, but I have it all here in my heart. I want you to know, I know the truth. I would be nothing without you. You ever know that you're my hero? And everything that I'd like to be, I could fly higher than an eagle. You are the wind.
You got a Love Island's on.
I want to couple up with this person because they have amazing dance moves and I love the way they do the Macarena. So the person I'd like to recouple with is... Simon.
What's your name, sir?
My name is John Courtney.
Where are you from?
I live in a village called Mosley, which is near Manchester.
Oh, OK. Have you brought anyone with you?
I've got my wife and two boys, I hear.
Brilliant. How long have you played the piano?
Since I was about five, I guess.
And is that how you make a living?
Yeah.
So is this the biggest venue you've performed in?
Yeah. The Palladium is like the Holy Grail to me. I used to watch the shows with my dad, and this is the home of variety.
Oh.
Overwhelming. It's amazing.
Oh, he's so happy.
Good luck, John.
Thank you. This is bonkers.
There was a man who had a dream that Simon Cowell and his team would watch him play piano and try to slay them on the stage of the Palladium. And in the time that one song took, David would write another book. Alicia would smile at him. Amanda would be kind to him. Simon's teeth would be blinding him if he was smiling. But nothing now could ever spoil the dream he dreamed like Susan Boyle.
I like this already. Yes, John.
Let's see if we haven't been in it yet.
Fact is, he never thought he'd ever get to be in front of millions of people doing his thing on TV. 30 years of playing in piano bars and pubs, dodging glasses when they're thrown, being thrown out of clubs. When your children ask, Daddy, when you're coming home, this game is not the same when you're just Daddy on the phone. So he sits at the piano and he tries to get prepared, thinking he'll write it in third person so he doesn't feel as scared to sing about himself to a bunch of strangers in the dark. But then Britain has got talent and he wants to make his mark. Paul Potts won the first year and said it was insane. The second year George Sampson won, singing in the rain. Lost Voice Guys season 12 and last year Colin Thackeray. So why not me?
Yeah, why not you? Why not you?
That's what he said, his youngest boy, one night in bed. Dad, why not you? Go and show them what you do. And even though you'll be a wreck, at least you'll meet Anton Deck.
Ah, we made it,
we're in it!
Yeah!
And he thinks on stage, at this stage in his life, with an expensive mortgage and a pensive wife. His youngest son, Alfie, says, what's it all about? If he had any hair left, he'd pull it out. His teenage son said, His dad taught him to play piano, but he didn't live to see his son at the famous theatre performing on TV. If he didn't see it through, imagine how sad the look on the faces of both his lads, who always tell him, you're the greatest showman, Dad.
they'll see me on BGT. No more third person, just daddy. This is me.
Fault a bit, I don't know why. I just saw a man who kind of made all his dreams come true.
It really was, yeah.
David.
It was just so winning, wasn't it? Yeah. I mean, my goodness me, it made the whole audience, and I'm sure everyone watching at home, just fall in love with him.
I love him.
He had everything, and at the end, he had us moved to tears. This show is perfect for you, and now I want to see you go as far as you can in this competition.
Wow.
Well done.
John,
it was just a wonderful audition. You're somebody who's worked for years, needs a break. You'll get a huge reaction of this, I promise you. And we all want you to do well, so I would love to be the first to say yes.
I can't believe you did that.
You deserve it. You deserve it.
Here's the other son. Here he comes.
I'm Axel Blake and I'm from West London.
So, Axel, what made you sign up for BGT this year?
Well, I've got a 12-year-old son. He's in the audience.
Nice.
Yeah. So I just wanted him to believe in yourself, you know? Put your mind to it and you can make it happen.
And do you have a day job?
Yes, I do property maintenance. If you need a kitchen done, Simon, let me know.
I do, actually, Axel.
Give me a call.
I will.
Good.
I want a good rate.
No.
We're friends now.
Yeah, OK, cool. Press that and we're cool, yeah?
I'm really curious with you, because you've got your day job, this is obviously what you want to do. Has there ever been a moment where you've almost lost your confidence and thought, I'm not going to do this?
100%, it's been that time. But when you have family that's looking at you and inspired by you, that's what keeps you going.
Yeah.
So my son and my daughter, that's the reason. That's the reason.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck. Go for it.
How are we doing, ladies and gentlemen? Make some noise! I was going to drive here today. I realised I don't have a licence, so... Don't worry, I drove anyways. I took the tube. I've got a love-hate relationship with the tube, you know? I love when it's empty, I hate when it's packed. Can't stand it. Fight people off for the armrest. You ever done that? No, you don't. This old lady's strong. Oh, my... Have it, Margaret, have it. Just have it. Some people do their makeup on the tube as well. Make some noise if you've ever done your makeup on the tube. Woo! Legend. A couple weeks ago, I saw a woman, she was doing her whole makeup. A few stops later, she was a whole new person. I was so impressed, I started clapping. I was like, you know what? Yeah, you know. She looked down on me like, I thought, you may be a 9 out of 10 now, but you was a minus 2 at King's Cross, life. Yeah. Boom. Yeah. I walked off the train like this, in style, yeah. Well, on a brighter note, just recently my fiance gave birth to a little baby girl. Don't clap, Simon, don't clap. I didn't say the baby's mine, did I? I'm joking, she's mine. Pandemic baby as well, you know? Aww. Yeah, so we went to give her a fitting name, so we named her Pfizer, yeah? Yeah. I call her Faisha, yeah? Faisha.
Oh, he's very good.
Technology is moving at such a crazy speed. Evolving crazy. You got the metaverse, you know, you got cryptocurrency. I still get excited about my contactless card when I use it. I do, when I use it, beep. I love the noise. I've got a jacket with a pocket on his arm. Sometimes I'll leave my card in the arm and I'll pay with my arm. Just to confuse the cashier. That was £19.30. Boop. Next week I'm going back, I'm gonna leave my card in my back pocket. I'll be £22.60. Boop. Yeah. Yeah. Then I walk off in style. Who's in a happy relationship? Make some noise. Yeah, me and my fiance have been together for years. And my friends ask me, how do you do it? How are you together for so long? Through the pandemic, baby. And I just say, find your woman that, you know, loves you, understands your flaws, and find your woman that has a good sense of humor. Just make sure those three women don't find out about each other. That's a trick. Yeah, but we don't really have issues. In fact, I'm like, the biggest issue we have is I hate when she would imitate my voice in an argument and it sounds nothing like my voice. I can't stand it. She'd come up to me, I asked you what time you're coming home and you said to me, I don't know what time you're coming home. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. What I do now, I've got a way to get her back. I imitate her voice back and guess what? She don't like it. I did tell you what time I was coming home and you said, well, make sure you come back at this time. I don't sound like that. Yes, you do. She gets angry. Get out of my face, get out of my face. I say, all right, I'll get out of your face. But how do I do it? In style.
Yay! In style!
My name's Axel Blake, thank you.
What did you think?
A comedy superstar is born tonight on that stage. So funny. You made it all seem so effortless. You got a wonderful, so likable personality. And everything you said was brilliantly funny and original. I loved it, Axel.
Thank you.
Well done, Axel. Super, super, super confident. The first person, honestly, who's ever made a joke about COVID and was funny. I know it's a bit of a cliche, but, you know, after what everybody's gone through over the last couple of years, boy, A, we needed this show back on air. We needed acts like you. There's one thing I have to tell you, though. I kind of like a granite top. I like a waste disposal unit. I want 25% off, and you get this.
Yeah.
for you.
Thank you. Thank
you. You needed
thank
you.
Absolutely brilliant. Good for you.
Simon's face is like this.
Look at Simon's face.
In Norway, that means you're doing really good.
Oh. Is there any more? Is there any more?
Come on, please.
Honestly? Okay, any more?
You want more?
No. No.
I love this app so much!